This is the first major update to Ireland's animal welfare legislation in over 100 years. What kind of research and work has gone into developing it?
Well, a lot of research by both the last government, to be fair to them, and now this government as well. This has been one of the priorities for me. Really, Ireland is operating under a legal structure around animal health and welfare that's just totally outdated.
Liam Kinsler, Inspector for the Dublin SPCA. The new legislation proposed, we would see it as a huge asset in the prevention of cruelty to animals and also the prosecution of people for animal cruelty.
This is a case file that we would prepare for a little West Highland Terrier who was beaten by a person with a baseball bat. But we would have fee charts, we would have photographs, we would have a listing of the first clinical examination and so forth. Then we would have a full veterinary report in veterinary terms and also in layperson's terms for the guard and for the courts.
But really what this is about is building on what the government has already done around dog breeding legislation, greyhound welfare legislation, horse welfare and horse identification regulations that I've introduced around the need for passports and microchipping and so on. It's building on the fact that despite we had to make a lot of cuts last year, we actually increased the level of financial support for animal welfare organisations because they're one of the sort of unspoken of casualties of recession when people can no longer keep horses or dogs or pets and they often get abandoned. And so we need to put resources in place to ensure that that we can deal in a compassionate way with that problem.
Then we will have photographic evidence taken by veterinary surgeon or the inspector for the courts to see the extent of the injuries, and the veterinary officer will give evidence in court as to, in her opinion, how these injuries were caused and the extent of the injuries. And in this case, this little fella lost the eye, most of the teeth were gone, you can see the damage. This was from a metal bat. And then you can see the extensive bruising on the animal after the vet had shaved the animal. So we prepare that whole file in that setup. We present that file to the guard in question from whichever local station takes it on. And then he will caution the person, question them, and then submit the file. This one came back and we had a successful conclusion. He was found guilty and he was fined €1,500, which is unprecedented. The normal fines we are used to getting would be €150, €200, or in some cases as little as €50. There's a huge cost attached to the investigation of this by the inspectors and the preparation of the file. And we are now, under the new legislation, there is provisions made to recover the costs to the DSPCA or to the minister. So that's another bonus to us because it's a drain on our resources. We're doing this every day of the week, every week of the year. We are dealing with these cases and preparing case files for the guards.
I'm Brian Gillen. I'm the CEO of the Dublin SPCA here in Kilfarnham. The society was founded about 173 years ago, so we're on the go quite a while. Our main purpose in life is the rescue of injured and cruelty cases, animals that have been neglected in some way. We bring them here to the shelter, we repair those animals, we provide them with veterinary care, we then get the animals where the objective is to try and rehome the animals, to try and find their as we call it, their permanent home. Well, this is Skip. I suppose he's in animal welfare, one has to keep one's sense of humour. But there is a sad story behind Skip. He's here about a year. He was found in a skip with his face burned. So he was taken in here, treated by the vets. He went through our treatment centre and he's successfully been rehomed with one of our staff. As you can see, he's a dog with lots of personality. So he lives here. He comes to work every day. And he's around the shelter. Meets and greets people as they come to visit us. So he has a new life and a new role, better than being in the bottom of a skip on fire.
Currently, our welfare legislation essentially makes cruelty illegal. right? In simple terms. And that isn't good enough, because you can only make a prosecution after there is proven cruelty to an animal or neglect. What this is about is essentially putting a new understanding around a code of practice and responsibility that an animal owner or someone who's responsible for an animal has to actually safeguard the welfare of that animal. And it allows us to intervene at an early stage, before cruelty may have occurred. It allows us to intervene at an early stage if, for example, there is a disease spreading where we need to isolate that disease to make sure that it doesn't spread any further. So there are broad applications for what we're doing here. And then we have some specific things that we're looking to really stamp out in Ireland, like, for example, dogfighting and cockfighting.
This year, we will rescue, give or take, 4,000 animals. Now, that can be across, that's across very many species. We rescue, for example, wild boars this year. We'll rescue 800 or 900 wild boars this year. Members of the public will ring us up and it'll be a seagull or a pigeon and we will go and rescue the animal and bring it here. We deal with the normal cats and dogs that everybody would associate with the Dublin SPCA. But it's in recent years there's been a little bit more animal, more exotic animals, as people with their tastes in terms of what animals they would keep. So we would, on site here, we would have snakes, we would have ferrets, we would have pot-bellied pigs, we'd have goats, we'd have lambs, we have any, you name it, it's like Noah's Ark in terms of the volume and types of different animals that we have.
Well, my name is Gillian Bird, I'm head of education here in the Dublin SPCA. My friend here is Beckham, he is my valued companion. Beckham came into the DSPCA in March 2002, he was a cruelty case. He was actually found in a back garden and the owner admitted to giving him only one tin of dog food every 3 days for a 6 month period, so he was incredibly skinny when we found him. We were actually very successful with the prosecution with his owner. His owner was banned for life on owning a dog, which is something that doesn't happen very often, and we were delighted with. He's named Beckham for any of your watchers, after Victoria, not David, because he was so skinny. But Beckham is great. He actually comes with me and does all of our school talks and helps me teaching children about empathy, which we feel in the Dublin SPCA is really, really important. And we can always ask him a question, if you like, as to what he thinks of the new animal welfare bill. Beckham, what do you think of the new animal welfare bill? There you are.